to another commentary done by Diggity. This is going to be BSL Season 13 Group D. We got Pepper, aka Keen, going up against Fischei, and this is going to be a really incredible match. Although it could be pretty laggy between these two, because you got Fischei, who, because I believe Keen, US Zerg, and he's a strong Zerg player. Honestly, I feel like last season he dropped out a little bit earlier than I was expecting, and I think that was in Chobo League. So I'm not surprised to see him in Hasuleague this time around. He's been really radically improving. His PVZ is, or sorry, his ZVP is fairly strong, but he is going up against Fischei. Fischei, the other German Protoss, who is a very, very strong player. And again, one of those guys that I almost feel like if he hadn't run in, it's one of those contests between him and Master Ray. It feels like 6 out of 10 times Master Ray is going to take this, but Fischei's definitely a contender. And I know he's very serious about this season of Hasuleague. Also very strong guy. This is going to be on Ascension, it looks like. And we are seeing that Probe Scout move to the 12 o'clock location. The other thing about Fischei is, you know what's, it's weird. It's like the German Protoss effect. He reminds me very much of Master Ray. I don't want to say like he reminds me of Master Ray or Master Ray reminds me of him. It's like, this just, he has like this, maybe I'm making a stereotype that doesn't exist here, but it just seems like there's these German Protoss players that are just extremely intelligent, good decision-making Protoss players, where they're very strategic and have really good analytical skills. Is this like a, I don't know, I feel like I'm not sure if I'm trying to make a, I'm not trying to be a stereotype here or not, I just feel that really embodies both these guys. Anyway, we see the spawning pool after hatchery, around the 2 minute mark. No gas as of yet. Probe doing a little bit of harassment. We are seeing the Nexus, which is, after getting all that scouting information, can go ahead and sneak that down. I'm wondering if he's gonna go, so not all, opening gateway first. And Pepper, aka Keen, still trying to get his initial scout off. I feel like Keen's strength is more in the mid game. Sometimes I feel like he can struggle a little bit getting his footing in the early game. The one thing though is if you let Keen get into the mid game and get comfortable, that is where he can be a very devastating player. And I'm almost wondering if Fischei is going to capitalize on that and go for one of those 7 minute, 30 second zealot timing attacks. Looks like that, I take it back, that Overlord finding it. Quick third hatchery. Third hatchery before gas for Keen. We'll see how this build order plays out. So he's gonna go for a big early economic pump and dropping that tech a little bit, finally grabbing gas, but this Fischei is gonna spot that at the 3 minute mark, and I'm almost wondering if he's gonna opt to skip Stargate altogether as a result of this. Photon Cannon preventatively on that front door with those Zerglings being produced. Still no Zealot in production. The Zerglings flooding out, trying to catch that probe and having trouble doing so. This is a big dedication. I actually like this decision to produce this many Zerglings to try to kill this probe scout, but the thing is, you're going to build that many Zerglings, you want to make absolutely sure that this probe can't sneak out and find that third hatchery and get the timing on it. Looks like one Zergling just peeling off, the rest staying at home base. In the meantime, gas filtering in. Fischei is going to go ahead and drop that side, but he's got that assimilator up. No second assimilator at this stage of the build order. Does have that single zealot, not yet plugging the gap. Really isn't, doesn't really need to do so. It looks like the Zerglings, yeah, now finding out. This is a huge moment here, is if these Zerglings, I feel like Fischei has a good idea that there's already a hatchery there. But regardless, not getting the pure confirmation is critical. Layer morphing in, cybernetics core behind this, and Fischei, pretty decent saturated natural expansion, now has that second assimilator. I want to see what build order he moves into, because this has been kind of a, and I think he's got an eye on that creep, so he knows that third hatchery is there. So you can go ahead and bring that probe home, especially seeing the 3 minute gas, seeing the edge of the creep. He knows he's going up against an early potential three hatch build. He doesn't get a good look at the drone line to know whether he's going up against 973, but I think he's got a pretty good instinct of it. A zealot actually moving out, and the probe against the six Zerglings able to go ahead and wander into the main and get a look at the lair. Citadel of Adun plopping down, a Stargate alongside with it, and this is going to give a big indicator to Fischei that needs to plant cannons preventatively in his main. Now granted, you gotta respect potential hatchery play, losing the probe scout there. This is where Zerg players can be very flexible these days, and oftentimes opt, I love this zealot sneaking through, might even be, should be able to get a drone kill at the very least, disrupt some of the mining here at this third base. And it looks like the Zerglings at a position to engage it. So a bit of mining disruption. The Zerglings now cycling back to go ahead and engage this. Nice defense by Keen, though. He was able to preserve basically all of his drones, get a decent surround on this zealot, but that's still economic time lost. The zealot not able to get into the back of the gap. Looks like it's going to go ahead and get annihilated back there. But sacrificial for the cause. First Corsair being produced. Templar Archives up. But because of the delay in that gas, this initial Corsair is going to be way ahead of the Spire. Way ahead of the Spire. Fourth hatchery plopped down. So this is more at the come at me Zerg style. The lap back to the four hatchery SimCity at the natural. And Keen's build order, although it's solid, is just very late with that Spire because he went for that third hatchery before gas. Fischei able to capitalize on it, and he's going to be able to get one, maybe even two Overlord kills. So the first one's going to go down. That's going to stymie the economy a little bit. Plus, losing some of that timing at that third. So I feel like Fischei doing exactly what he needs to do in this match. So Keen currently in the red, trying to get Phenomenized Carapace up. Has that Hydral's Den, doesn't really have any anti-air out as well. There's the Spire. Usually you want the initial Scourge out here to go ahead and take down that first Corsair and also get a scout in your opponent's base with this build order. But in the meantime, it looks like he might lose that second Overlord before pretty close to when the... Actually, where the Scourge? Pretty close to when the Scourge are popping. So there the Scourge pops. Just barely able to get that Corsair before that Overlord is taken out. But that's going to be a tap to take out that Corsair in the near future. Also, Dark Templar, with that delayed build order, starting to move out on the field to get a degree of map control for Fischei. He's still been mining out of that double gas, continuing to produce Corsair to maintain air control and force Keen in more defensive position. Keen does have that evolution chamber up, is going for level 1 spines, has a handful of Hydralisks right there. Those Corsair can go ahead and back off, but keep in mind there's still this Overlord they can snipe over that corner as soon as they find it. Dark Templar engaging. Looks like that is going to be well defended. Somehow able to... That was odd. I wonder if that was like an egg effect? Getting a little bit glitched through the wall, and I almost thought that might be advantageous. But in the meantime, Fischei sitting at an incredible probe count. Two saturated bases. Level 1 weapons is going to be here. He's been able to be pretty comfortable, get a decent Corsair count in the mid-game. And this feels like a hyper-modern Protoss style that I actually like the most. And he's doing a good job of exactly what I love seeing, although the only thing I see missing from Fischei is it looks like rather than having some Zealots at this stage of the game, he has opted for High Templar, and he has dropped down a lot of Photon Cannons in anticipation of a potential all-in from Keen. So Keen, with looks like he's plopping, and Keen actually is, yeah, he's produced a lot of Hydralisks, but he's still macroing a bit behind this, kind of going back between the two, and this is where I like seeing those Zealots in the mid-game. Specifically to kind of wander out in the field, because with this large Corsair count, knocking down these Overlords, looks like another Overlord going to get picked off. This does have Phenomenized Carapace, but keep in mind, it takes a while for the Hydralisks to get in position to defend this. Able to pick off one Corsair right there, and every Corsair counts, so that hurts. But I love this style of Protoss play. I've seen Dreamer execute it really the strongest, where you just clear out vision from your Zerg opponent in the middle, so they just don't know where you're at. They don't know where your Corsair fleet is, they don't know where the rest of your troops are. Looks like Keen taking this opportunity to, like, okay, I'm in a defensive posture, I'm just going to stay in a defensive posture, move out with more Hydralisks to that 9 o'clock location, also camping critically this third, and this is a critical thing for Fischei. He does need, behind this, he does need to get in a position to go ahead to take a third base, or be in a position to take a third base, and Keen doing a pretty good job of defending up, getting his drone count up, establishing additional base to play that economic lead. Fischei producing, playing a little bit more defensively. Despite, honestly, I feel like he had decent scouting information to recognize that it wasn't a contained situation. Level 1 weapons now online for these Hydralisks, and Keen, playing a little bit more defensive, has macroed up considerably. The High Templar Zealots now moving out. Looks like they're going to be able to clear that Zergling. I like the Zerglings on the ground. I usually like seeing the Dark Templar clear that out again to create a bit of darkness, but now Keen knows that there's some troops out here. But even with these Zealots and these High Templar, if there's some magic storms, it should be able to obliterate this attack force. However, if Keen can just micro it and do some Psystorm dodging, he should have enough, so he should have something sufficient to deal with this, but certainly going to lose some Overlords as he's moving out here. The Hydralisk getting pinned into the corner. Keen not reacting very well. And actually just straight moving these Hydralisks through. All the Overlords getting picked off. And a beautiful Psystorm. Unfortunately, the Psystorm landing a bit on the High Templar as well. But Keen losing a Hydralisk army in the middle of the map. But he does have reinforcements that he can go ahead and engage. But he needs to go ahead and defend this 9 o'clock base rapidly. And this is Psystorm bait right here. This is not where he wants to engage. Also in the red, losing those Overlords midfield. The Zealots are getting preoccupied. They're going to go ahead and engage uphill into a losing battle, I believe. A Psystorm being dropped. A nice dodge from Keen. And Fischei, yeah, looks like he's going to get one drone out of this. And that is not the trade he was looking for his entire army, particularly when he hasn't been establishing a third base behind this. So Fischei still with the supply lead, still with the worker lead. But Keen still holds this fourth base. The Zealot's going to go ahead and get cleaned up in the midst of this. So a big so Fischei losing his army, now starting to move out, try to get some cannons down at that third. The Zergling sees it, but Keen, if he reacts rapidly enough, could honestly just move in with the Hydralisks he has and pin that down. Fischei trying to sneak some Zealots through. He's going to go ahead and try to shoot that gap to try to push this back. There is a Sim City there, but no Hydralisks behind it to go ahead and defend. So this is a nice play by Fischei, getting a lot of value out of just these two little Zealots running through. More Hydralisks pushing up, and it looks like Keen, sticking on the defense, maybe doesn't realize how small an attack force Fischei had behind this. Keen about even on supply. Let's see if he drops a second evolution chamber. I'm looking to see if there's a second forge. That forge currently silent. Still one forge. So the second forge just now being dropped. Seven gateways behind this. The Corsair fleet looks like it had gotten knocked out in the midst of that. So we got two Corsairs now starting to push out. More Zealots moving out for Fischei to again force Keen to stay on the defensive, but we do have Lurkers on the ground. Critically though, Keen not in a soft defensive position. Those Lurkers aren't planted. The Zealots able to kind of yakety sacks their way out of this. Another two Zealots going to shoot that gap, and I like this play from Fischei to try to force Keen on the defensive. It looks like those Zealots once again going to try to run through into the main, but unfortunately, this is a great third to assault for Keen. It's high ground to low ground. This is a huge amount of Hydralisks. They are decently upgraded. The Bolt Corsair is getting knocked out. A couple drones being picked off here in the line. Let's see if Keen responds to that. So it looks like he's going to try to focus on this attack instead before these cannons are warping in. This is a decent size storm on top of the Lurkers before they're planted, but a lot of Lurkers planting down otherwise. Fortunately, yeah, the Lurkers being wiped out. This is a very late robotics. I don't see an Observer in the air. Some beautiful size storms from Fischei to go ahead and clean that army up. And so Keen, losing a lot of that army, still has some Lurkers standing. Fischei initially pulling out, but I think with the Psystorms, he might be able to push the rest of this back. We'll have to see momentarily, but it looks like the drone's getting completely obliterated, or at least pulled out in the main. So a lot of disrupted mining there. Keep in mind, there's still three bases behind this. Now the Observers joining up. So Fischei finding a pocket between all of those Psystorms and a distractionary attack, eating a little bit of his own Psystorm there, to go ahead and get his third up. However, Keen is still at a decent drone count. He's actually ahead level 2 weapons in the upgrade war. Nice play from Keen, actually going ahead and plopping this Zergling at the 5 o'clock location. Gonna see these Zealots moving in. So Fischei thinking about, so we're gonna looking at a big positional macro game. Fischei pulling ahead in that last exchange. Looks like Keen hasn't resaturated that main. He's getting a second evolution chamber down and going to move towards Queen's Nest. So Fischei in an okay position right now. Does have the double forge spinning to try to push that upgrade advantage. And I think he might be able to sneak it briefly. I'm not sure if that's going to be a large enough window to capitalize on, to be honest. But Keen in the meantime has pretty decent, well, natural expansion, not that great, isn't amazingly saturated. Decent saturation here, decent saturation here. If he can get his drones saturated out, he's going to be in a really strong economic position. Fischei, though, doing a fantastic job macroing, just getting all sorts of troop counts out. Looks like he's going to just wind to the upper right-hand corner to go ahead, excuse me, and grab an additional Nexus there. Bit of a forays into the middle of the map with the Zealots. And usually at this stage, in this style of Zerg, what you'll see is it's more of a soft contain of Lurkers across the middle of the map to prevent this sort of troop movement. And that is one thing that Keen is lacking. He's going to go ahead and try to grab this inside 9 o'clock. And he's planting a very, very, honestly, this feels like a very avoidable, very engageable contain in the middle of the map. Now starting to move those Lurkers down, but this isn't before Fischei is able to kind of get position, although his Zealot's eating an immense amount of damage before turning around. Finally, some Psystorm to engage, hitting two Lurkers and a Hydralisk. The Hydralisk's now engaging from behind, just blanketing Psystorm in the midst of this. So what was lacking in initial Zealot engagement might be made up for with just incredible Psystorms that Keen just doesn't seem to be able to micro out of as far as the follow-up, but it looks like Keen is going to be able to push Fischei back in the midst of this. A High Templar getting picked off, the Dragoons wandering forward, Fischei having trouble controlling his army and keeping it cohesive. The Dragoons just wandering forward and getting wiped out. And you can see where that losing all of those Zealots initially and not being able to stop them and turn around was costly. So supply counts once again even. Not a huge loss for Fischei. He wanted to get some damage done. He wanted to try to keep Keen honest. However, he's still able to establish this base in that upper right-hand corner. So it's not like a starvation situation. However, he's not able to stop the inside nine from going up. We'll see if that gets saturated. It's one thing having the base. It's another thing having it actually mining. But critically, Keen is at Hive Tech behind this. And as soon as we start seeing those critical pieces like that, actually, he could probably go to Ultralisk Cavern here with the amount of gas. He's got four gas up and running, and he's still got plenty of gas in this main extractor to roll with, and that is a scary situation to be in as a Protoss opponent, where you have a four gas Zerg that is rolling in his economy and feels very confident to the point where he's trying to control the entire middle of the map. No Ultralisk Cavern down, no Defiler Mound either. A lot of Dragoons in the midst of this, some High Templar in the midst of it as well, starting to peek forward. And again, Fischei with some trailed observers running in wholesale, those Dragoons taking a lot of initial damage. The Hydralisks re-engaging from the north, a Psystorm blanking them from there, but honestly, it feels like the trades are working out pretty well for Keen. He's able to push this army back, some Zerglings sneaking in. That Adrenal upgrade on those Zerglings is going to make them so devastating in a minute. And the Dragoons just getting wiped out. Yeah, Fischei is just going to have to camp back. I'm hoping to see a robotics facility back here, excuse me, and a robotic support bay to try to deal with what is going to be an oncoming onslaught. Hydralisk actually pressing in, bit of Psystorm on the gap, trying to engage a cutoff route. Looks like he is able to sweep through, but Keen getting a little bit too aggressive. I'm actually a little bit surprised he decided to display that aggression, considering he does have Hive Tech up and he is trying to grab that inside 12. Luring some Zealots back to that Lurker line. So holding kind of the middle of the map, and Keen has everything right now. Did I miss a Storm Drop or something? I missed something, I think, in the main here. Or maybe just a little bit of scattering at the main. I don't think so. I don't see a Shuttle or anything nearby. Maybe a Tide midfield. The one thing for Keen is he is missing a... Well, he's got okay hatcheries behind this. There's some macro hatches. See if he can keep up with the upgrades. Grabbing some more macro hatches, yeah, behind this. Still not seeing the Defiler Mound or the Ultralisk Cavern. And again, I feel like he's got the gas to make it happen. It looks like currently, though, he wants to stick on Hydra Lurker. Fischei, even in supply. Level 2 weapons, level 2 armor. Against level 2 weapons, level 1 armor. Some Scourge right there along the corner. He's going to go ahead, and I think I know this is going to turn into a longer macro game. Let's not panic. Let's try to force better trades overall. And this, in this situation, it almost feels like a little bit of a race to me between the Defiler Mound and Dark Swarm planting, or a lot of the gas being able to plant at the upgrades and a potential Ultralisk Cavern. Right now, though, Keen is showing no indications of a tech shift to late game. Fischei starting to make his way towards 200 supply, even supply counts again. Fischei with a little bit better, nice size storms right there. Fighting uphill, unfortunately, against the Dragoon, against the Lurkers in the middle of the map. Keen doesn't have his Hydralisk force to respond to this rapidly, but now all sorts of troops grouping up. Fischei not doing a full dedication. Now that those are bunched up, that might be potential size storm bait. But Fischei just trying to play a soft defensive game, and these Zerglings are going to be able to get on top of this. And once those the Zerglings pulling back, getting obliterated in the midst of a lot of that Psystorming. Keen looks like he might lose a bit of this interior contain. Fischei still standing, just being patient, letting the army to come to him on the low ground. And Keen is letting that happen. He's continuing to attack into the low ground, lose a lot of troops. And so now Fischei, yeah, just holding up. Let's see if he drops some Psystorms to go ahead and penetrate if he's just going to walk uphill. A lot of misfires there. But yeah, able to clean up everything in the middle. Keen falling apart a little bit. Maybe doesn't have his armies hotkeyed up to be able to respond to this. So Fischei able to carve out a bit of territory in the middle. Now Zerglings starting to move up, but not before the Zealots are there to just wholesale engage. Looks like some Zerglings are able to get on top of the Dragoons to the left. They're getting cleared out by that Psystorm very cleanly by Fischei. And Fischei just very, very patiently and very calculatedly starting to walk into the middle of the map. Drawing that up and pulling back. I think he realized he just was losing army cohesion previously, and that was what was costing him a lot of these battles. And right now, looking pretty good. King's still continuing to surge a lot of troops out to engage this, but he's not getting the better part of any of these battles thus far. Just eating Psystorm, and Fischei just migrating the Zealots in to engage the Zerglings, dropping Psystorm behind to clear them out. But it looks like this is just overwhelming attack force for Keen. He's starting to push through. But still, if we look at the raw army count, 171 for Fischei, 140 for Keen. And still no indications of tier 3 tech behind any of this. Looks like that third base just about mined out. Still plenty of bases for Keen. See if he keeps up on those upgrades. It looks like he's getting ventral sacks to potentially go drop on top of this. Keen still trying to hold the middle of the map, but honestly, Fischei is happy to let him do that. Let's see if Fischei, continuing to Psystorm and do a handful of engagements here and there. Some Zerglings grouping up to the north. Keen really pressing this, really does not want this army here. In the meantime, though, Fischei is down to two bases, and Keen is effectively still at four or five. More Zerglings flooding forward. They're happy to just go at, Keen's like, you know what? I feel like I'm in a strong enough economic position where, and I think he's correct, where I'm just going to throw troops at you endlessly and not let you establish an additional base. I take it back. It's three bases for Fischei. And Fischei eating a bit of Psystorm on his own troops. Let's see, is he just going to... But still, I feel like that was favorable trades from Fischei all the way around. So inside, 3 o'clock location's been taken. Fischei now grabbing the bottom right-hand corner. He's still mining in that upper right, but his main and natural expansion are expended. In the meantime, Keen's main looking thin. His natural expansion not very well saturated. 9 o'clock base is decently saturated. Inside 9 as well. The Zerglings going to try to end around this army. It looks like they are going to force a cancellation at that 5 o'clock base. Lurker's trying to gather up on that high ground to maybe get an assault point. And Fischei now starting to end around and move that army. This isn't the engagement point he wants, though. He doesn't want to attack that army uphill, though Keen isn't dedicating a lot to that attack force. In the midst of this, so Keen... missed a storm drop briefly, obliterating that line. Some Zealots dropping. Keen down to 52. That was one of his major mining bases. Some Scourge moving in. Looks like they are going to be able to take out that shuttle. But that's going to force Keen into a defensive slot, which might open up an attack up on this high ground. Reaver, if it has an Observer, could clear that out. Like seeing the Reavers at this stage. And this, it feels like Fischei... I like the way he's playing this. He's like, okay, this is going to turn into a long-term economic game. I'm just going to slow play this, get all the things I need to play a really defensive shelled game, and force Keen to just walk into unfavorable trades, get my Reavers at my expansions, and slowly walk, take my portion of the map. Keen trying to counterattack here in the upper right and corner. Reavers not here yet. The Zerglings are flooding in. There's no Dark Swarm, which would have been a real cap on this, but the Zerglings, keep in mind, do have that Adrenal upgrade, which means they chew through this very, very rapidly. So nice positional counterattack. Fischei counterattacking in the middle, but the Observer is somewhat out of position. He wants to try to clear the middle of the map. The Zerglings re-engaging right there. And Fischei, just marching through the middle of this, trying to do a tit-for-tat situation, but Keen has enough of an economy that he's rolling. He's repositioning the Lurkers to the middle of the map, has wiped out upper right. That is a big loss for Fischei. If he can clear out the middle of the map, that might be an even trade, but that has yet to be seen. Both players plummeting in supply. The Reaver a bit exposed underneath. Psystorms, nice Psystorms from Fischei, but it looks like Fischei is going to end up losing his army in the middle of the map. So Keen with some nice positional play and a battle probe in the midst of this. No kills yet. Don't worry, probe. You'll get your opportunity. Observer killed overhead. Both Observers picked off. Now it is just High Templar and 3 Dragoons, and Keen still holds the middle, and that might have been the moment that sealed this match Keen recognizing that there wasn't enough defense in that upper end corner. If that Reaver had just been a little bit earlier for Fischei, that might have been a different scenario. And Keen continuing to expand behind this as well. So great plays all the way around from Keen. Keen with the supply lead. Level 3 weapons, level 2 armor, by the way, so this is a very powerful attack force versus level 3 weapons, level 3 armor. But Fischei down to one mining base right here, and it is getting, you can see very Saren Zerg style, everything swarming this mid position. The Zealots looking to engage. The Lurkers able to make short work of them, and the Zerglings now starting to flood through. Hydralisks, Lurkers, and Zerglings, oh my. And that is going to be GG. Fischei. That's unfortunate. Fischei, I thought he was walking into a good position, but Keen just able to find that one moment to attack that upper right-hand corner. Still trying to defend this desperately, but a single Reaver, 3 Dragoons, and 2 Zealots is not going to get it done. And this is just a cleanup operation now for Keen. He's got bases all over the place. Keen just trying to expend the rest of his army to see if he can magically maybe try to reseal this. I think as soon as he realizes he can't, that will be GG. And this is a gap that you don't want to shoot with Lurkers in the way. So he is no longer mining. He's down to 91 resources. So if he's going to try to win it, he's got to win it with whatever he's got. And in the meantime, Keen has just all sorts of resources. But playing honorable Protoss style, he's going to fight the last man. He's going to send those units. This is the thing about Protoss. Those units want to sacrifice themselves for the cause. Even more so than Zerg, I think. Because Zerg, it's like you're just part of a giant liquid thing. You're going to turn back into liquid. It's like you're coming back anyway, right? For Protoss, it's like you're an autonomous being. You want to die for the cause. You're not a mindless brute. Push out there. So Fischei allowing his troops to get that last honorable moment before calling the GG. Distance mining, this is cute, from Fischei from the upper right-hand corner. But Keen has this all but one. 53 supply. There's GG. Well fought by both players. This is going to be a fun match between these two guys, I can tell. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for listening.